So you set up a fish tank recently, and it's starting to give you some weird issues. We're going to talk about a lot of different scenarios that you might go through and what you can do to get your tank back on track. We have a great example today because if you are watching along, you know we set up this avatar-style aquarium a few weeks ago, and we're starting to see some issues with algae. We want to eventually get to a point where we have an aquarium like this that doesn't really have any issues at all. It's super in balance, and we just have to feed our fish and enjoy our aquarium. Don't get me wrong, that tank isn't 100% perfect, but it's super manageable, and that's always the goal. Don't pay attention to this, it's under construction, we're gonna focus over here. Guys, there can be a lot of issues with a new tank. You've probably heard of new tank syndrome. When people mention new tank syndrome, they're most of the time talking about nitrogen. So their nitrogen cycle is all out of whack and it's causing them problems. I kind of loosely use the term to describe all things that can happen to a new aquarium that aren't good. So I just wanted to make that super clear. We will talk about that a little bit more in this video. So if that's your problem, we'll get to it. But let's start here with this tank. I think the most common thing for a new aquarium to go through is just the algae period that you might experience a couple days to a few weeks into setting up that new tank. So this tank, obviously we have some weird green slimy algae that's on our glass. So you can see me removing it here with the blade of our flipper, makes it really easy. Unfortunately, the side stuff isn't gonna be able to get got by this thing. We're gonna have to get in here with a wand or some kind of manual thing to get that, as well as the back glass. But why did we even get to this point, and why is this algae in particular our problem? Every aquarium that you set up is very different, even if you are using similar materials. Subtle differences can make a huge impact on your tank, so just know that my aquarium here is probably not like your aquarium that you have at home, and these problems are probably not the same as yours, but we can take everything that we learn in this video and apply it to pretty much any aquarium. When we first set up a tank, we have a whole list of things that we are fighting against. One is nutrients. So depending on what you put in your tank, you might have more of a nutrient problem than a different tank that has different materials in it. I find that aquariums that have a lot of wood in them typically have a little bit of a harder time getting going, and they do experience issues with algae more frequently. That's basically just because wood is constantly decaying. Some woods are gonna decay slower than others, but if you have a ton of it, then you're gonna have a constant source of that nutrient, that decomposition that's always taking place. So in this aquarium, we don't have a ton of wood. We have some sprinkled in here, but that's probably not the source of our algae in here. We also don't have a lot of fish. We're not really putting any food into this aquarium. So why is this algae happening? It's most likely happening because we are putting quite a bit of CO2 into this aquarium to help encourage our plant growth. But just the fact that it is so new, it hasn't really established how it wants to be. The microorganisms in here have not found their niche per se, and so we are just kind of sitting back and waiting for enough time to go by and for things to get situated. I know that kind of sounds like a lame answer because it's sort of not tangible in a lot of ways, making it hard to pinpoint exactly what you can do, but that's just the truth of it, is that sometimes aquariums just take time to get rid of their problems, with intervention, of course. So the type of intervention that we're gonna do for this aquarium is water changes and manual removal. If we were adding things like fertilizer to this aquarium, which we're not, we would probably pull back on that and not do it at all just to kind of get through this period. But I think that's really all we're gonna have to do with this aquarium is give it time, do our manual removal, scrape our algae off of the glass, do probably a 50% water change on this thing, and then keep doing that probably once or twice a week. And that's basically gonna be my prescription for these kind of problems with your new tank. There's not really much else you can do, unless you're doing something really weird. Like I mentioned, adding a ton of fertilizer, you're probably gonna wanna walk that back a little bit. If you're just dumping a ton of food into a tank that has a ton of fish, you might wanna consider moving some of them to a different tank or to a new tank altogether to lighten that fish load. We always wanna make sure that our inputs do not overreach the ability of our tank to handle those inputs, if that makes sense. And that's really the story with this tank. I mean, we went through a long period of having some string algae growing on the Monte Carlo and battling with some algae down here in the hair grass as well. It really just took time, and it took the plants getting to a certain level to be able to handle anything that we throw at this. Fertilizer, the CO2, lots of feeding, more fish, etc. It was just time. So here we are, post-water change, guys. Changed about 50 to 80% of the water, somewhere in there, and I felt like that was enough. As you can see, the tank is a lot more clear. We don't have nearly as much of that green, dusty algae on the glass, which is also helping, but it's not perfect, right? Like, it's not gonna be something that we can just fix with one water change, so this is a routine that I'm going to do to this aquarium in particular, probably 2 to 3 times a week. I won't have to do it for very long though, so probably, I mean, you never know, but I'm imagining having to do this for like 2 weeks. As soon as I stop seeing that green algae, then we'll cut back on the water changes and we'll get into a more stable approach of, you know, like a 25% water change once every 2 weeks or so. Doing water changes is really the only natural thing that you have in fighting sort of that new tank syndrome-y things like algae, nitrogen imbalance, of course. And it's something that I eventually try and never have to do to my tanks. That's always the goal. The problem with your tank is actual new tank syndrome in that you have an imbalance of nitrogen, maybe you have some ammonia in the aquarium, or you have nitrite detectable on your test kit. Well, then you definitely need to be doing some big water changes. Hopefully you don't have fish in the aquarium, but if you did a fish in cycle and you're getting a little worried because those concentrations are getting high, then you might want to consider taking them out. The easiest way to avoid new tank syndrome is to add some beneficial bacteria to your tank before you put your fish in. Using beneficial bacteria is something that you can use even if you've already started. Okay, it's never too late to add this stuff. Sometimes, you know, randomly I'll pour some of this in if I've been doing a lot of water changes, just out of peace of mind, but you can never go wrong with some Turbo Start from Fritz. If you have a planted tank that's at least medium planted, kind of like this one, you shouldn't have any issue with nitrogen being out of balance in your aquarium, guys. Okay, it's something that just isn't gonna happen. That's what the plants are there for. So use nature to its advantage, put a bunch of plants in your tank, and you're gonna have less problems overall. That goes for algae as well. The more plants you have in the tank doing their job, the less chances you're gonna have of something weird happening and your tank ending up being a nightmare that you don't wanna deal with. Another thing that can happen to especially a new aquarium is what we call a surface film. Luckily, I don't have any tanks right now that have a surface film, so I can't show you exactly what it is, but just imagine a bunch of bacteria or a layer of bacteria on top of some stagnant water. Chances are you've seen this before. You're gonna most commonly see it in tanks where you don't have the water moving around, so like on a no-filter beta tank like this one right here. Now, the reason why we've never had that problem in this tank is a few different reasons. One of them, I think, being the fact that we have a lot of floating plants up here. Floating plants are, of course, gonna help to reduce the nutrient content of your water, which is just another reason for why they're such a great tool for a lot of different problems. If nutrients are a thing, add some floating plants. I'm talking Sylvinia, even duckweed. I know that's not for everybody, but you can get some bigger stuff, this kind of like giant duckweed almost, it's easier to clean up, red root floaters, things of that nature. The easiest way, of course, to prevent any sort of surface film is to have good water surface agitation. So if your tank is large, then you're probably gonna wanna be using a canister filter. We, of course, use Awaza canister filters. They're a channel sponsor. We really like their stuff. Built-in heaters, you guys know the drill. I think a pretty common thing for especially new fish keepers is to not have the appropriate filter for the size of tank that they have. So I mean, like, if somebody has a 55 and they use like a hang-on back filter, that's something that I wouldn't do. You certainly can, but I think you're gonna run into more issues like surface films. You're not really getting a good distribution of water throughout your tank, and that's important for a lot of reasons. So over here on our smaller tanks, this is a 6-gallon water box. We have a little Dimax hang-on bag filter. That's just fine because this is a really small volume of water. Excuse for the mess, we're in the process of redoing this guy. But for any tanks, I wanna say over 30 gallons, you're probably definitely gonna wanna use a canister filter. It's just gonna help distribute everything in the aquarium that much more. And of course, we need to move nutrients around for our plants and we wanna do the best we can. So, with that said, guys, I think that's probably my whole spiel here on common things that can happen to a new tank that can cause people problems. You can see it's a few days later, and we do have this algae coming back, so we need to do our entire maintenance routine on this thing again, and that's what I'm gonna be doing right now. But I won't bore you with that. Thank you guys so much for watching. I look forward to seeing you guys all at Aquashella Dallas here this weekend, Halloween weekend. I'm gonna be there this year in a slightly different capacity. That's all I'm gonna say for now, but I'm really looking forward to it. I love going to trade shows. Aquashella is obviously the most fun trade show by far, at least in my opinion, and it's gonna be great. So yeah, it's gonna be a lot of fun. I hope to see some of you guys there. Thank you for watching this video. I hope it helped somebody in some way, and we will see you in the next one.